Outside of the major cities and away from the highways, much of France is largely empty. In Burgundy, the countryside features farmhouses made of native stone, newly planted fields, and herds of livestock. Our first destination was the medieval town of Flavigny. The abbey here was constructed in the early 700s by Benedictine monks. 1,000 years later, they were forced to abandon the site after the French Revolution. Catherine Trubeau's grandfather bought the empty abbey in 1923 and continued a tradition begun by the ancient monks, making candy based around tiny anise seeds imported from Spain.
This is the anise seed. You can see? You can smell. You smell?
Oh, yeah.
Very small
anise. There's one of these little seeds in the middle of all the candy.
Yes.
The seeds are spun around in heated vats and sprayed with a sugar solution every 2 minutes, growing in size like a rolling snowball. Eventually, they're packaged and shipped all over the world, including the United States.
It was the oldest candy in France, and I'm very proud of that, and I want to go home, because people like that.
40 years ago, the old abbey yielded up some unexpected treasures to Catherine's grandfather. While digging in his garden one day, he discovered an ancient vaulted chapel that had been buried and forgotten for centuries.
When they find that, they are so happy.
Oh, I bet.
Oh, yeah. They make a lot of picture and just such like that. Wonderful.
One of the best examples I know of the easy Burgundian mixture of past and present is in the hilltop town of Flavigny. Once it was famous for its abbey, and in a sense still is. But the abbey was appropriated from the monks during the French Revolution and is now the sweet factory of the Trubeau family. So the buildings are a period piece and the firm's a period piece, because apart from the 1920s machinery, it is indeed like a family, stuffed with relations and friends. But the history of the sweet goes back an incredibly long way for something the size of an aniseed ball, for something which is an aniseed ball. Flavinius the Roman probably brought aniseed with him when he settled here half a century before Christ.
Here is a candy. Here is a seed. There is a lot of candy.
Who made the first aniseed ball? When? No one knows, but heaven help them. In the 17th century, rolling them in sugar by hand took 6 months. Even now it's 3 weeks.
It's what sort of stone?
But go across the factory yard into the abbey crypt and see what they've got. When she was a child, Catherine Trubeau used to play here, among many ages of Burgundy. Her grandfather had discovered the place only a few years before.
Yeah. He was on his garden hut and tried to find like that, and he found all this crypt.
Really?
Yes, really. Nobody knows there is that here.
Ages of stonework leading back into the past, the great days of the abbey, a Roman temple, a Celtic face from a pre-Christian shrine.
Is there anything else left underneath us, do you think?
Yeah. I think perhaps there is something down, but I'm not sure. Archaeologists say me not to touch now, but in my dream there is something.
You have dreams about this place?
Yes, a lot of dreams, and my cousin too, my brother, my sister.
What do you dream?
I find something marvelous, like Alibaba, you know, not money, things like that, stone, very nice, sculpture, statues, story, perhaps an anise, very old with a story.